Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the Honda K20 versus K24, which one is better. The Honda K-Series engines were initially introduced in 2001, and the K-Series is made up of all double overhead cam inline four engines, being that the K20 and K24 are both from the same K-Series engine family. The two engines do share much of their design in common, and so there are a lot of similarities between the K20 and K24. Now jumping in, one of the biggest differences between these two engines is that the K20, as the numbers suggest, is a 2.0-liter engine, whereas the Honda K24 is a 2.4-liter engine, so that difference in displacement is really one of the biggest differences between the K20 and K24, and the way Honda achieved the larger displacement of the K24 was by heightening the deck of the engine block and then significantly increasing the stroke of the engine, so that'll tie into a little bit of the performance that we discuss in a moment, but ultimately main point there is these engines do share much in common. With that said, let's go ahead and jump in and compare these engines a little further in depth, starting with Honda K20 versus K24 performance. Some key performance differences between the Honda K20 and the K24. Again, with the K24 being the slightly larger engine, it is going to offer the most power potential, especially if you're looking at aftermarket modifications and upgrading these engines. The larger displacement K24 simply has the advantage for peak power output there. More importantly, one of the main benefits of the K24 engine is the fact that it has the longer stroke, and a longer stroke really helps with low end torque. If you drive both of these engines, you will notice that there is a significant difference in torque, especially in the lower end of the RPM range. Now, as for the K20, one of its benefits with the shorter stroke is that that allows for slower piston speeds and really allows the K20 to rev a lot higher. A lot of the Honda K20 variants can rev to 7,800, 8,000 plus RPMs, and compare that to the Honda K24, in which many of those engine variants redline much closer to about 6,800 to 7,100 RPMs. So that is a big advantage to the K20, is it is a very rev happy, high revving engine, and a lot of Honda enthusiasts really appreciate the K20 engine for those reasons. Now, when it comes to factory performance, believe it or not, the Honda K20 actually offers the highest power variance from the factory, and that is because the K24 was never turbocharged from the factory. And on the other hand, the Honda K20, specifically the K20C Earth Dreams engine, was turbocharged from the factory, so that can offer up to 320 horsepower, which is significantly more than any K24 variance ever offered from the factory. Again, boiling down to the fact that the K20 had that turbocharger from the factory. Anyway, with all that being said, it is tough to compare performance specifically between the K20 and the K24, just because when you look at the variants and subvariants of these engines, there are 30 plus variants and subvariants of the K20 and K24. So the biggest takeaway is just kind of some of the general key points, in that the K24 has a larger displacement, so it's going to have the higher power potential and better low end torque, and the K20 is going to be the more rev happy, high revving engine between the two. And so if you really are looking for the ultimate performance build of the K20 or K24, it's actually a combination of both engines. One really common configuration with the K20 and K24 is using K20 A2 cylinder heads on the K24 A2 cylinder block, which gives you a happy balance between both of the engines, with the K20 head flowing a little bit better and having a higher rev nature. And then on the other hand, getting the larger 2.4-liter block kind of gives you the best of both worlds of low-end torque, peak performance potential, as well as high revving. Moving on to Honda K20 versus K24 reliability, there isn't really much to talk about reliability-wise or problem-wise with either of these engines. All of the K-Series, the K20 and K24 included, are incredibly reliable engines and really do not suffer many common problems or design flaws. Now, with that being said, both of these engines do share a couple common problems. Common in air quotations for a reason, because they're not truly common issues. Just when issues do pop up, these are a couple of the issues that are more common than others, and that is oil leaks from the front main seal, as well as cam lobe galling. Certainly doesn't mean that they're common and happen on a large percentage of engines or vehicles. Just a couple things to be on the lookout for with either engine. Otherwise, when it comes to K20 versus K24 reliability, there really isn't any clear winner. Again, they're both incredibly reliable engines. A lot of it really just boils down to maintenance and repair history and how well the engine and vehicle has been taken care of. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our biggest topics for the K20 versus K24 comparison. In summary, the K24 just has the displacement advantage and the low-end torque advantage. The K20, on the other hand, is going to be the higher revving engine, and that does add some fun and excitement to the Honda K20 engines. Looking at reliability, no clear winner between the two. Both excellent engines, incredibly reliable, especially when they're well maintained and well taken care of. So if you are looking for a K20 or a K24 powered vehicle, or looking to swap one of these engines into your existing vehicle, there isn't really a right or a wrong answer. When you do start diving into all of the different variants and subvariants, some are more ideal than others and some a little bit less ideal than others. But ultimately, both the K20 and K24 are incredible engines and have a lot to offer. Finally, if you are looking to do an ultimate build, it really is a combination of the two engines that you can get an incredible build out of. Again, combining the K20 cylinder heads with the larger K24 block. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.